Today, this is the chemistry class number 41. And we have 15 group elements in that. That is properties of ammonia. You have prepared the ammonia already by Haber's process also, laboratory reference, etc., etc. Now, the properties of ammonia is. So, let me know the shape of this ammonia molecule. See, you know the shape of this ammonia molecule. This is the shape of the ammonia molecule. See. That is a lone pair of electrons are present on the nitrogen atom, and this is a pyramidal shape. You see, pyramidal shape, trigonal pyramidal shape. Let us say trigonal pyramidal shape with three hydrogen atoms. Attached to nitrogen atom. The nitrogen atom is at the apex of the hydrogen atom. You see, lone pair of electrons are present on the apex of the nitrogen atom. So here we have three bond pairs. You see, 1, 2, 3, three bond pairs, and one lone pair of electrons, of course, of electrons. And here the band angle is, it is about the 107.8 degree, and the bond length between nitrogen and hydrogen is about 1.7 picometer. So this is the that is shape of the molecule, shape of ammonia. That is, the ammonia molecule is trigonal bipyramidal, that is pyramidal shape, and the nitrogen atom is bonded to three hydrogen atoms, where the lone pair of electrons are present on the apex of the nitrogen atom. So therefore, we have three bond pairs of electrons and lone pair of electrons we have in nitrogen, that is ammonia molecule. So after that, you see, second one. So this solubility of ammonia, you see, solubility of ammonia. We know that, you see, ammonia is a pungent smelling gas. Ammonia is a pungent smelling gas, and it is soluble in water and forming the hydroxyl ions, solubility. So if you write that is NH3 plus H2O, you will be getting NH4 plus plus OH minus. So that means NH3 plus H2O, you will be getting NH4 plus plus OH minus. So because ammonia is a base, and it is a weakly basic in nature, you see. So what acts as acid and ammonia is the base, therefore water donates a proton to the ammonia, and you will be getting NH4 plus and OH minus. Due to the formation of OH minus ions in solution, it is acts as a base, you see, basic in nature. Of course, it is weakly basic in nature. So after that, solubility, you see. So since it is basic in nature, ammonia is basic in nature, it reacts with acids. Because it is acidic in nature, it reacts with what? Acids, giving salts. We know that when bases react with acids, you will be getting salts. So for example, you see NH3 when react with HCl. So HCl is an acid, ammonia is a base, you will be getting NH4Cl. NH4Cl. And ammonia will react with HNO3 if you get nitric acid. So this is hydrochloric acid, this is nitric acid. NH3 plus HNO3, you will be getting NH3 plus HNH4. You see, NH4, that is NH3 plus one more H, NH4, NO3, ammonium nitrate, you see, ammonium chloride, ammonium nitrate, both are salts. And if you take NH3 plus H2SO4, you see, H2SO4 is sulfuric acid, it is hydrochloric acid, nitric acid, sulfuric acid. So this sulfuric acid plus NH3, we will be getting NH4 plus SO4, you see, ammonium sulfate. So ammonia reacts with sulfuric acid, giving ammonium sulfate. That means, you see, ammonia being basic in nature, it reacts with acids forming their respective salts, ammonium chloride, ammonium nitrate, ammonium sulfate. Okay, so these are the equations. So reaction with acids forming their respective bases, salts, you see, salts. And after that, reaction with one more compound, which is zinc sulfate. What is the action of ammonia with zinc sulfate solution? So we know that ammonia in the aqueous medium behaves as ammonium hydroxide. We have already known that you see NH plus H2O, NH4 plus OH minus, which is nothing but ammonium hydroxide. That means you see ammonia in the aqueous solution acts as ammonium hydroxide. So therefore, let me take that zinc sulfate plus ammonia in the form of that is ammonium hydroxide, you see, NH4OH. So then what happens? Zinc sulfate reacts with ammonium hydroxide, that is ammonia in the form of ammonium hydroxide. Okay. So that is ZnSO4 plus NH4OH will get it. ZnOH twice, you see. Zinc hydroxide will be getting ZnOH twice. That means you have to put 2 here, ZnOH twice plus ammonium sulfate will be getting NH4 twice, SO4. Here you see this zinc hydroxide. What is this? Zinc hydroxide is a white precipitate, remember. Is that white precipitate? So after that, that is zinc sulfate reacts with ammonium hydroxide solution, giving zinc hydroxide ammonium sulfate solution. And second property, next property is reacts with ferric chloride. You see, ferric chloride. Ferric chloride, FeCl3 solution. What happens when ammonia in the form of ammonium hydroxide reacts with ferric chloride solution? Then we write the equation here. You see, you can write the equation like this: FeCl3 plus NH4OH. You see, NH4OH. So you will be getting, that is, if you write 3 NH4OH for valence in the chemical equation, FeOH dies. What is FeOH? Ferric hydroxide. It is reddish brown precipitate. Remember, it is reddish brown precipitate. Plus 3NH4 plus 3Cl, 3NH4Cl. So ammonium chloride will be made. So that means, so there is ammonium hydroxide or ammonia in form of ammonium hydroxide reacts with ferric chloride, giving reddish brown precipitate of what? Ferric hydroxide. So that is the equation and the reaction. So after that, one more reaction is there. So reaction with the metal ions. How does this ammonia react with metal ions? Like metal ions. Like here we are going to take copper ion as a silver ion. Copper ion and what? Silver ion. So generally, when metal ions react with your ammonia, it forms a complex. It forms a complex salt. For example, if you take that is a Cu2 plus ion with 4 NH3, you see, 4 NH3. So here you see, why? Because so this formation of complex takes place due to the lone pair, sharing of lone pair of electrons present on the nitrogen atom. So that is donation of lone pair of electrons by the ammonia is part of the Lewis base, you see. Lewis base. So why it is called a Lewis base? Ammonia acts as a Lewis base because you see, so lone pair of electrons present on the nitrogen atom is capable of donating. Okay, that is lone pair of electrons present in the nitrogen atom. So donates the lone pair of electron to the metal ions so that they form some metal complexes. You see, that is a complex compounds are formed. That is Cu2 plus plus 4 NH3. You will get it Cu NH3 4 times 2 plus ion. That is called the cupramonium ion. You see. Cupramonium ion. It is not copper ion, not ammonium ion, it is cupramonium ion, that is for the complex ion. Okay, so how actually it is, you see, that is Cu2 plus, it is bonded with, coordinated with, that is NH3, lone pair, all the lone pair of electrons, have been bonded with the copper ion, you see. So that is Cu2+, that is 2+. That means you see, so lone pair of electrons present on the nitrogen atoms have been donated to the central metal atom. As a result, we get the cupramonium ion, which is called the complex ion. Okay. So that means you see, ammonia being a lone pair of electron present on the nitrogen atom acts as a Lewis base, which can donate the lone pair of electrons forming with the metal ions, forming what? Complex ions. Okay. So this is one example. You can write one more example also, that is with the silver ion. That is actually, you know that you see Ag plus plus Cl minus, you will be getting AgCl. So directly I am going to write this ammonia, that is NH3, 2NH3 plus AgCl. You will be getting Ag NH3 twice Cl. So this is a diamine silver chloride, diamine silver chloride, which is a complex salt, you see, it is a complex salt. So this is how some metal ions like silver ion and copper ion forms, that is the complexes with that is ammonia molecule, you see. So therefore ammonia donate the number of electrons to the metal ions forming complex ions. That is the meaning of this reaction. So after that, one more concept is there with respect to your nitrogen. So oxides of nitrogen, you see, oxides of nitrogen. We that means you see, when nitrogen reacts with oxygen, we told that you see nitrogen forms two types of oxides. That is the trioxides and what pentoxides, right? N2O3, N2O5, like that. But here you see when oxygen, that is nitrogen reacts with oxygen, it gives many number of types of oxides generally. So that is those oxides are nothing but N2O, N2O, N2O3, N2O2, N2O4, N2O5. See here? So nitrous oxide. What is that? Nitrous oxide, nitric oxide, nitrogen trioxide, nitrogen dioxide, nitrogen tetroxide, nitrogen pentoxide. We can calculate the oxidation state in this also. How actually you see, that is 2x, yeah, you put a, that is x power n, you see. Okay, N2O means that is 2 into n. Okay, that means 2n, 2, sorry, 2 into x. That is instead of nitrogen you put that is 2x, that is oxygen is minus 2, that will be equal to 0. 2x minus 2 is equal to 0. What is 2x is equal to what? 2. Therefore, x is equal to what? 2 by 2, that will be equal to what? 1. Oxidation state is what? Plus 1. Okay. Here, nitric oxide, that is x minus 2 is equal to 0, therefore, x is equal to 2, you see. So, this is plus 2. Oxidation state of nitrogen is what? Plus 2. That is N2O3. How much? How much? That is 2x minus 2 is 6 is equal to 0. Therefore, 2x is equal to 6. Therefore, x is equal to what? 3. So, this is plus 3. And this is nitrogen dioxide, you see. X minus 4 is equal to 0. Therefore, x is equal to what? 4. That is plus 4. So, here N2O4. That is 2x minus 8 is equal to 0. 2x is equal to 8. Therefore, x is equal to what? 4, you see. Plus 4. So, here, that is 2x minus 10 is equal to 0, therefore 2x is equal to 10, and x is equal to 1, 5, that is plus 5. This is the oxidation state of all these oxides, you see. We can ask your, that is C or anything, you see, complete your examination. What is oxidation state of nitrogen dioxide? Plus 3, you see. So this is plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, this is plus 5. Okay, so this is how we have many number of oxides of nitrogen, that is nitrous oxide, nitric oxide, nitrogen trioxide, nitrogen dioxide, and nitrogen tetroxide, nitrogen pentoxide. Okay, so these are the oxides of nitrogen. Okay. After this, one more compound is there, which is nothing but nitric acid, you see. Nitric acid. So that is the first compound is ammonia, second compound is nitric acid, HNO3, you see. HNO3. Next compound is HNO3, which is nothing but HNO3, nitric acid. Nitric acid. We know that you see nitric acid is the acid, that is the acid which can be prepared by that is your Ostwald's process, which is already explained in your last classes. You see, how is nitric acid manufactured by what? Ostwald's process. I will explain. But here you see, I will take the laboratory preparation. You see, laboratory preparation of HNO3 nitric acid. So here, for the preparation of nitric acid in the laboratory, we have that is sodium nitrate, you see, NaNO3, or potassium nitrate, you can take. And it is made to react with sulfuric oxide and sulfuric acid. Okay, so here, when sodium nitrate is heated with oxygen and sulfuric acid, you see, by this action, you will be getting nitric acid. So that is, you will be getting 2NaNO3 plus H2SO4, you will be getting Na2SO4. Here, NaNO4 plus 2HNO3, yes, here sodium nitrate reacts with sulfuric acid, giving sodium sulfate and what? Nitric acid. Second one is if you write KNO3, so that is H2SO4, But here you see it will be KHS of 4. Potassium bisulfate. KHS of 4. One more H is there. HNO3 will be released. Right. So this is how you can prepare the lactic acid in the laboratory. Laboratory preparation of lactic acid. It is your syllabus of course. But generally, for the nitric acid manufacture is asked for your examination. That is manufacture of nitric acid by osmosis process. I have explained. However, I will explain that again. You see here itself. That is nitric acid manufacture. Manufacture of HNO3 nitric acid by Ostwald process. You see Ostwald's process. It is for 3-mark question. It is a 3-mark question. You see, and you have to write 3 equations correctly. So this manufacture of nitric acid involves 3 steps. You see, in the first step, oxidation of ammonia into NO into nitric oxide. You see, nitric oxide. So this is the first step. Oxidation of ammonia into nitric oxide. Now actually there is 4NH3 plus 5O2 undergoes oxidation. Okay, in terms of platinum, rhodium, bars as catalyst at about 500 Kelvin I suppose, and bar 9 bar of pressure. Okay, then you will get it, there is 4NO plus 6H2O. So this is ammonia undergoes oxidation with air in terms of platinum, rhodium, gases, catalyst at this temperature and pressure. So giving nitric oxide and water. This is the first step, you will be getting good mark. Second step you see. So again this nitric oxide undergoes oxidation to nitrogen dioxide. That is oxidation of NO into NO2 you see. NO into NO2. That is, for this you see, you have to write 2NO plus O2. You will get 2NO. That means nitric oxide undergoes oxidation giving nitrogen dioxide. You see, it is called the nitrogen dioxide. Nitrogen dioxide. This is the second step. Again, one more. So, third step you see. In the third step, absorption of NO2 by water. Giving HNO3. So this is the third step you see. That means you see HNO3 is formed by the absorption of nitrogen dioxide by water. You see, water will absorb nitrogen dioxide so that nitric acid is obtained. So for this we can write this equation, that is 3NO2 plus H2O. We will give you 2HNO3 plus NO. You see, getting NO. That means 3NO2 plus H2O. You will get 2HNO3 plus one more NO is obtained. You see, this nitric oxide is again reused again for this first step. You see, this nitric oxide can be recycled again, of course. Okay, this nitric acid obtained is about it is a dilute nitric acid. You see, of course, it is dilute nitric acid. Therefore, it is concentrated by heating to get 68% HNO3. That is, dilute nitric acid is further heated to get 68% HNO3, and it is a further subjected to fractional distillation by heating with sulfuric acid to get 98% HNO3, which is called the, that is highly concentrated nitric acid, which is called the water. Highly concentrated nitric acid by heating with sulfuric acid, which absorbs all the water molecules. Okay, that is how you can manufacture the nitric acid by Ostwald's process. First step, oxidation of ammonia into nitric oxide, write the equation. Second step, oxidation of this nitric oxide into nitrogen dioxide, write the equation. Third step, absorption of nitrogen dioxide by water, giving nitric acid, the third step. Okay. You will get it 3 months. So after this, you see, after the manufacture of nitric acid, you have some properties of nitric acid, you see. Properties of nitric acid. So nitric acid shows some chemical properties actually. So this nitric acid use some oxidizing properties, you see. Use some oxidizing what properties. I will show some oxidizing properties, you see here. Oxidizing properties. So generally, the oxidizing properties of nitric acid with metals, you see. With metals.
with metals depends upon the nature of the metal, nature of the concentration, that is nitric acid. What is the nature of nitric acid? Whether it may be dilute nitric acid or what concentrated nitric acid. So dilute nitric acid means products are different. Concentrated nitric acid means products are different. So therefore you see, so oxidizing properties of nitric acid depends upon the that is the nature of the concentrated nature of the acid, that is whether it is concentrated or not whatever. So next nature of the metal is highly that is reactive metals are that is mild metals let us say, right. So here we have again two metals you see, one is copper, second one is zinc, you see only two metals we have for this reaction you see. So first one is let me take the copper metal is first copper metal first case with concentrated HNO3. Let me write the equation for concentrated HNO3. So generally when concentrated nitric acid reacts with the copper metal, it gives nitrogen dioxide gases, it gives nitrogen what dioxide NO. So equation is Cu plus 4HNO3, you will be getting CuNO3 by plus 2H2O plus 2NO3. This is the final equation we have. Just here, copper reacts with concentrated nitric acid. Copper reacts with concentrated acid, giving cupric nitrate, forming water and liberating nitrogen dioxide. That means you see, concentrated nitric acid oxidizes copper into copper nitrate. Oxidizes copper into copper nitrate and itself reduces to nitrogen dioxide, that is the meaning of this. So this equation can also be resolved in the Long's formula. You see how actually that is 2HNO3, just here 2HNO3 is H2O plus 2NO2 plus O, just here 2HNO3 is H2O plus 2NO2 plus O. This can be written like this, you see. Now this Cu plus O gives rise to CuO. With Cu, this Cu plus O, this O. This cupric oxide further reacts with another 2HNO3 molecule. So giving CuNO3 twice plus H2O. And the equation cancels the common terms for both the sides. Cu cancels with CuO, O cancels with O. And the remaining equation is Cu, Cu, 2HNO3, 2HNO3, 4HNO3. Gives rise to CuNO3 twice. Plus H2O, H2O, how much? 2H2O, plus this is 2NO. So this is how you can write the equation for this. That means Cu plus 4HNO, CuNO2 plus 2H2O plus 2NO2. This is the single equation you see. This is the complete balanced chemical equation. This can be written like this. This can be written like this. So this is a dilute HNO, sorry, concentrated nitric acid with the copper. So second one is B with dilute HNO, dilute nitric acid, HNO3. For dilute nitric acid, it gives nitric oxide gas, you see. It gives nitrogen dioxide, it gives nitric acid. How actually we say, I will write the equation. 3Cu plus 8HNO3 gives rise to 3CuNO3 plus 4H2O plus 2NO2. So this is how we can write the final equation also easy. See here, 3Cu plus 8HNO3 gives rise to how much? 3CuNO3 plus how many H2O? 4H2O plus what? 2NO, that's all. 2NO, not nitrogen dioxide, it is a nitric oxide. So this is how you can write it. For this also, you can write the steps also. It is not necessary. You can remember and write several times so that it is very easy to write the equation. You see, 3Cu plus 8HNO3, but it is dilute HNO3. You see, if it is concentrated, you will be eating nitrogen dioxide. If it is dilute, you will be eating nitric oxide. Yes. Okay. So second, only one metal is another metal is there, that is zinc. You see, for this zinc, concentration only is same. You see, so just see here. That is, instead of copper, I am going to write zinc here. You see, zinc metal, Zn plus 4HNO3, Zn NO3 twice, you see, plus 2HO plus 2NO2. Everything is same. That is, concentrated nitric acid oxidizes zinc with zinc nitrate, liberating nitrogen dioxide gas.
But in the case of dilute chain only, it is different actually. It is different. Just see here. So how much you have to write? That is a 4ZnO plus how many HNO3? 10 HNO3 divided by how many ZnO3? 4 ZnO3 twice plus how many HNO3? 5H2O plus N2O. How many N2O? 5 that is 5N2O. Okay. That is nitrous oxide. You will be getting this 4 to the 8, only 1N2O you will be getting this. Why? Because that is 4 to the 8N is here. So therefore only 2N, that is N2O. That means you see, when the zinc reacts with the dilute HNO3, remember, when zinc reacts with dilute HNO3, you will be getting zinc nitride and nitrous oxide. It is very, very important. You see, nitrous oxide gas. Why? Because nitrous oxide is called the laughing gas. Laughing gas, you see, which is called the laughing gas? Nitrous oxide. So it is nitrous oxide is called the laughing gas. So it was invented by Humphrey Davy, you see. Humphrey Davy. Laughing gas, nitrous oxide. Okay, that completes the oxidizing properties of nitric acid with metals like zinc and copper. Okay. We'll stop at the stage.